Gekido. Gekido Bot Battles is a game by Come On, where you and a handful of players are going to be rolling dice, Yahtzee style, to try to get poker hands to do things. Let's see if we can get that glare off of there. This game is about giant robots, but it's actually about little robots. It's like the robot wars where the people have the little toaster ovens that do this and you gotta try to survive. Only this one has little minis that are fucking cool. Now these are the reason for the season. We have little cat, little bad butthole, little Sakurai chick, little dragoon, a samurai guy, and some kind of Tyrannosaurus lizard with a jetpack. Now these are very, very, very cool! Very, very, very cool! And they are the coolest part of the game! So what the game has you doing is on your turn, you're gonna take a handful of not very chunky dice, they're little bitty tiny dice, and you're gonna roll them! And then, depending on if you have some special abilities, you could re-roll to try to get poker hands. Now this is not the first game to allow you to roll dice to try to get poker hands, nor will it be the last, nor is it the best. I think that honor goes to Dice Town. Even, what was that dumb game that I played, Rail Raiders, also did this. Normally you're just kind of rolling dice to try to get a set, either some of a kind or whatever, but this one actually takes it a step further to try to get five of a kind, four of a kind, a full house, three of a kind, two pairs. So before the game, we're gonna set up our little grid. If you're playing with two players, it's a four grid. If you're playing with more people, it's a bigger grid. This is unnecessary. When you're playing with two people, you're moving up and down, but the abilities on the tiles do come into play as far as getting to re-roll or extra defense or whatever. I think this is dumb and you don't need it. Also, if you're playing with multiple people, you have targets because you have to target the person in order to shoot the person. This is also, I think, super dumb. I'm ragging on this game a lot already and we haven't even really told how to play. Fine, let's do it. So the first thing you have done is you have picked a character. If you are a normal human being, you have chosen Meow, who is this dildo-tailed looking cat right here, who is very cute and will destroy things. And then you have to figure if you're going to be playing with multiple people or two players. I do love it when a game company gives you dual-sided player boards depending on player count. So what you've done, you have shkaboom. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna roll these dice. Let's take a look at them. So you're rolling the dice, kaboom. And these dice have different symbols on them. And what you're trying to do is get two pair, three of a kind, a full house, four of a kind, five different, but it can't be the color that your person is. So this has to be five, the other five different of those, or five of a kind. And you're gonna get the opportunity to re-roll some of these. Now these are poker hands, but I like that they're poker hands without being Jack, King, Queen, Ace. They're shapes that you have to do poker hand stuff with. And that is cool. Now, what I do enjoy about the game is that you have to commit after your first roll which one of these you're gonna go for. Let's say I wanna go for the three of a kind and I have two of those ready to go. So here's what I have, and then other things being what they will allow me to re-roll and re-roll, but let's say I don't get what I need to complete that three of a kind. That first number is how much damage I would have dealt if I would have completed the three of a kind, but if I don't complete it, then I get the kablooey, and that's how much damage I get done. Damage is done with these tiny dice. Look at them, they're so cute. So everyone has this all filled up, and then when you take damage, it goes down to one until it goes away. And when a dice goes away, you get to add it over here. And then, so the more damage you do, so let's say for example, I get bopped here, I get to get a power or an upgrade. And that's what these are right here. So I can take a power, so I can put a one there, I can upgrade it to a two, a three. So the more beatings I take, the more special abilities I get, which is the cool, 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 cool part of the game. Also, it kind of shows with something opposite. So, because there's abilities that let you do it a flippy dippy. And then you can flippy dip it. That's it. Oh, one more thing. You also have cards, which they recommend you don't use in a two-player game and you don't need it. These are little things like flip a die to a color and prevent your bot from damage and flip a die. You play cards in the game. So what you're doing is rolling these dice to to try to get sets of things, to attack things, to make the dice go down to zero, and then to blow them up, and then they all die. And that's all you need to know to play Gekido, Gekido, Gekido. One of them. Phil will correct me. Ladies and gentlemen, let's do some housekeeping. It is for 2 to 4 players. I only played it with 2 people, or with me and 1 person, and it was really fun when we were playing it. And then when it was over, I was like, man, there are some really good ideas here. It's 1 or 2 steps away from being a really good game. But the problem is, I didn't really want to, you know, bring my family or anyone else into it. 2 to 4 players, nah. Ages 14 and up, because who the fuck knows. And then 45 minutes. With 2 players, it was a very, very fast game. This is a situation we have where it's like fighting big robots, but with little robots. And the minis admittedly are awesome. Cool mini or not, this is a cool mini. This isn't an or not. But the problem is, I got this game for $20. When it originally came out, it was like $55, $65, which I would have been capital P-ist if I got this game and it was $65 and this is what I got. These are the exact same cards they have in the Marvel United. So as a game itself, it's a couple of steps away from greatness. It's got some fun as far as just chucking dice trying to get a thing done. But I have better chucking dice trying to get a thing done games. It has poker hand making. I have better making poker hand games. If the dice were like twice as big and I was rolling big ass chunky handfuls of dice, it might be a lot cooler. But as it stands, Gekido Bot Battles. I got Russian there for a second. It is a dice driven fighting game by Phil Barros and Romulo Marquez. Boss, we'll get a West Island Games. That was neither Italian, nor Japanese, nor French, really. Anyway, this game is out of my hard 100. It's not a game that I care to play again. I had fun with it. The minis are super cool, but after you get over the initial, oh, awesome. Oh, cool, it's a cat. Oh, cool, it's a little dragon guy. Oh, this guy has a little thing, but you know, guess what? He's not gonna stand up. He doesn't stand up very well. Not really a lot to say about it. Played it. I enjoyed it for the one time that I played it, and I'm okay never playing it again. And that is not what a game needs to be if it wants to be in my collection, which also is not French. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining me on this, the latest edition of the Hard 100. This game is not right for my shelf, but if you have some younger kids who just, no, even then, it's $20 at half price. I don't feel like you get $20 worth of game in here. You get 20 bits, butts, books, bucks worth of plastic. This game needed to be bigger. These dice needed to be huge. These tiles needed to be huge. The board is boring. It's just the grid. I feel like it could have been, if it came with like a real board to move around in, even if it's static. I don't know. I feel like there's a great game in this box. But as I said, the game that's in this box is not the great game that it needs to be in this box. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you and yours are well. Wash your goddamn hands. Thank you for goddamn voting. Peace out.